Toda la gente salió corriendo del cuarto porque fue el día del temblor, el 19 de septiembre.
So, okay, thanks. So, the reason we're doing these Ditto X events, I've been in the music industry, you know, 10 or 12 years, and every event I ever went to, you used to see the big bosses of the companies, and you used to see people come on and give advice, but I never saw the people that were actively working in the music industry day to day, like myself and the people you're going to see here. Because surely the goal for all of us is to make money in our music career. It's just to make a music career and get paid for it. That's the goal. So tonight, we're going to bring out local people who are making a living in music, you know, and having success. And that's the knowledge we want to get over to everyone in the audience.
Todas las conferencias a las que había asistido siempre iban los presidentes o los CEOs de las compañías, pero realmente nunca hablaban con la gente que estaba haciendo el trabajo día a día, como es la gente que estamos aquí hoy y como el mismo Lee hace día a día. Entonces, el punto de la conferencia de hoy es justamente hablar con gente que está diario ejerciendo como músico, como empresario en la música, y justamente para poder realmente ser exitoso y tener todos los tips que nos puedan aportar aquí, ya que lo viven diario.
And the main thing we want to get over to everyone tonight, this is the best ever time to be a musician, ever. Statistically, it's the best ever time. Your chances of success are much higher now than they ever have been. I was in a band, and I was in a band for about 10 years, and back then the only way to release music was to have a CD and sign a record deal. And the whole perk, you'd spend 10 years playing in a band, and at the end of those 10 years, if you were really lucky, and I'm talking 1 in 100,000 people, you would sign a record deal. That's what it used to be like.
El mensaje que queremos dejar claro hoy es que es el mejor momento que nunca para ser músico. Lee estaba en una banda, estuvo con una banda durante 10 años y la única manera que se podía distribuir música en aquel entonces era por medio de un disco y tener un contrato con un sello discográfico, y era pues literalmente uno de cada 100,000 personas que les tocaba esa oportunidad y que ahora para nada.
But right now, it's all completely changed. Even back then, out of those 100,000 people, the one person that got signed, and I ended up signing a record deal, and I never released anything. I think there was a 1 in 10 chance of signing a record deal with a major label and releasing something. So you had a 1 in 1,000,000 chance of ever putting a song out. Right now, you can do it in 24 hours, you know, because of companies like Ditto and the way the music has evolved. So what we want to help you guys do today is have success in the new model of the industry.
Que aunque sí fue firmado por un sello, nunca lanzaron nada. Entonces eso todavía amplía la gama de posibilidades de no ser exitoso. Y ahora es todo lo contrario, por compañías como Ditto y otro tipo de compañías de este estilo, esta música ya la puedes hacer disponible en 24 horas.
So what I'd like to show you now are some slides from, you know, just to back up what I'm saying, from all over the world that show you the rise in digital music that is happening right now.
Entonces vamos a empezar con unas presentaciones para respaldar todo lo que estamos diciendo, para ver cómo va la curva de la industria de la música actualmente.
So this is the value of the music industry as we are today, up to 2018. Now, as we go to 2001, we were at our peak of CDs in the late 1990s. Now, everyone probably knows what happened here. Napster and peer-to-peer files.
Entonces, en el 2001, ahí la venta mayor era de CDs, de discos compactos, pero después sucedió Napster, MP3, etc., y empezó a cambiar.
This is the system that we still use now, through Spotify. Now you imagine being a record label in the year 2000, and someone comes in and says, I've created the easiest possible way for a fan to get your music. It's the best peer-to-peer system in the world ever. Any business person, surely a light bulb will go off and they say, that's brilliant. Do you know what the major labels did? They spent 10 years trying to sue the internet. They took a court case up against the internet. And as you can see, Everything went down for the next 10 years. Piracy shot up. No one wanted to pay for music. And the whole music industry was in complete freefall.
Entonces llegó alguien diciendo, tengo la solución, la mejor manera de hacer negocio con esto, es el mejor sistema de par a par. Y los sellos, en lugar de decir, cuéntanos más, le entramos, se pasaron 10 años peleando en contra de esto y lo único que ocasionó fue ese declive en ventas de música.
But then, in around 2014, Spotify started, you know, here, Spotify, Apple Music. Now, around this period of time, it started to become easier to stream music than pirate it. So you saw more users adopting streaming platforms right up to 2018. Now, the global revenue growth is up 10% from last year in the UK. Let's look at the next slide.
Entonces, aquí, alrededor de 2014, empezó a hacer algo importante con compañías como Spotify, Apple Music, y el crecimiento de revenue que podemos ver ahí global, 9.7%, 19.1 billones.
Goldman Sachs, who are, you know, one of the most esteemed companies in the world for reporting, have now said that we are here at 10 billion, and the value of the whole music industry is going to go up to 35 billion per year in the next 10 years. So it's going to do another 3x in the next 10 years just because of streaming.
Entonces, en teoría, la mejor compañía en cuanto a reportes de este tipo está estipulando que en los siguientes 10 años va a subir a 35 billones en puro streaming.
So this is just some more statistics from Goldman Sachs.
Aquí más estadísticas de Goldman Sachs, que es la compañía.
As we look around the world, China had a 35% increase in the music industry in 2017.
En 2017, China tuvo un crecimiento de 35% en la industria de la música.
India 27%.
En la India 27%.
You don't find that in any other industry, gold, metal, you know, chemicals, no other industry has as much money coming into it right now as the music industry does, and has more investors coming into it because Goldman Sachs are the people that are pumping money into the industry.
Ninguna otra industria tiene tanto crecimiento y por lo tanto tanta inversión.
So when you read about the stories of people saying that, you know, streaming is killing music, it's simply not true. When you look at it, Ed Sheeran back in, I think, 2015, broke a streaming record, and he did 1 million streams in a day.
Cuando se escuchan las leyendas urbanas de que el streaming está matando la industria, simplemente no es cierto. En el 2015, Ed Sheeran llegó a 1 million de reproducciones en un día.
Right now, artists are doing up to 15 million streams per day with one song.
Y ahora hay artistas que están llegando hasta 15 millones de reproducciones con una sola canción.
So while before you were earning £5,000 per song, they're now earning £75,000 per day from Spotify for one song.
Entonces, mientras que antes ganabas 5,000 libras por una canción, ahora se pueden ganar hasta 75,000 libras por día por canción.
And you're probably thinking, that's Ed Sheeran, that doesn't affect me. But the point I'm trying to get across is 27% increase in people coming onto a streaming platform means that even the songs at the bottom are going to start streaming more. If you have a song that was doing 100,000 streams a year, it's now going to do 150,000 streams a year, and you're going to make more money.
Entonces, no, esto no nada más se queda en, bueno, eso le pasó a Ed Sheeran, qué bueno, a mí qué. Sino que, sin embargo, las canciones que están hasta abajo, digamos, o sea, si alcanzaron 100,000 reproducciones en un año, entonces el siguiente año van a llegar a 150,000 reproducciones.
And at Ditto, we have thousands of musicians who are now making a living from music, which, as I said before, is the goal we all have. You know, they may be earning $2,000 to $3,000 a month on streaming or Apple, but they're making a living from music.
Y ahora en Ditto tenemos artistas que viven de su música. O sea, puede que nada más estén ganando $2,000 or $3,000 al mes, pero viven de su música.
So, and as I've done these events, everyone's asked me the same questions. How do I make it in music? How do I do this? How do I do that? And the truth is, I don't know, because every artist out there has had a different path,
and a different way of, you know, pushing those guys themselves out into their audience.
Entonces cuando me preguntan cómo la hago en la industria de la música, pues la respuesta es no lo sé, porque cada artista tiene un camino diferente, desde cómo llegó hasta cómo desarrollarse.
So what we're going to do tonight is bring out people locally, as I said before, who are making money in music, who can give you tips on how to get more streams, who can help you, you know how to put a strategy together, and are going to give you active advice for the next 2 to 5 years on your career.
Y lo que vamos a hacer hoy es justamente hablar con gente local que vive de la música y que nos puede dar consejos y tips de cómo llevarlo a cabo cada uno en nuestra propia carrera.
And from Ditto, you know, we want to come back next year and we want to do this again, and we want to have artists, you know, that we're helping, you know, build sustainable careers in the music industry and getting paid.
Y por parte de Ditto queremos hacer esto cada año y justamente tener artistas que están ganando y viviendo de lo que están haciendo con nosotros.
So I hope everyone has a great time tonight. Ask as many questions as you want. We'll all be around at the back afterwards if anyone wants to ask me anything at all. Our whole purpose of being here is to help you out, so remember that. Any questions you have, we're here to answer. And I hope everyone has a great Ditto X. Thank you.
Pásenla increíble todos. Cualquier duda, aquí estaremos.